Here's the fact. Trump is the least of our problems. He is a simple study at this point. Trump is toxic, period. Sure, he's going to go out with a bang, as in trying to blow up as much as he can. He is absolutely trying to make nothing better, despite the fact that America is in a time of abject crisis. He knows this. He doesn't care. So he's not working on the pandemic that is worse than ever. That he's not making a deal happen on relief when more people are struggling to put food on the damn table than at any time in this country since my parents were babies during the Great Depression. Trump is so far gone that I cannot in good conscience play the substance of a 46-minute spiel that he spewed tonight. It is lies and ugly suggestions that have a basis in nothing but division and malice. It is a spiel, it is a con, only to benefit his own coffers, as followers continue, most in good faith, to donate to a cause for an alleged billionaire, despite the fact that that cause is already over. But again, Trump, I argue to you, is the least of our problems. My focus tonight with you is on those who remain, those who empowered his deception, whose silence should deafen all ears craving decency. The GOP is no more. It is the Trump Party. You electeds are nothing but re-Trumplicans now. If I'm wrong, where have you been for a month? Trump has never produced a shred of proof of any suggestion, and you know it. Rudy, the other jesters, no court has found anything significant to any outcome, and you know it. No Republican in charge in any of the states in question says differently, and you know it. The guy you put in place at the federal level to secure the election says there was no substantial fraud. Even Bill Barr, an attorney general that will be remembered for his bending over backwards to protect the president, even he says the election should stand. And what do we get from you? Instead of echoing the obvious, you join Trump in tearing down those who dare to defy. But it is you, men and women, who are in trouble. You have traded loyalty to oath and office to fealty to a toxic man. Who am I talking about? You got McConnell, you got McCarthy, of course. But specific examples, Marco Rubio, senator from Florida, he sounded the sirens during the campaign. Remember when he looked at you and talked about the great American of Donald Trump.
A con artist is about to take over the Republican Party and the conservative movement, and we have to put a stop to it. Donald Trump is a con artist.
I will never allow a con artist to take control of the party of Lincoln and Reagan.
Who knew that his awkward water grab would be far from his lowest moments? Never say never. Rubio has proven to be every bit as small as Trump suggested by calling him Little Marco. He quotes the Bible all the time, but he never speaks truth to power. Ted Cruz, senator from Texas, urging the Supreme Court now to help overturn Biden's victory. He offers no solid basis. This is about the loose ground of an awkward appeal to other Trumpers who, by the way, will never accept you. Another sitting Senate Republican, the chairman of the Homeland Security Committee, Senator Ron Johnson, urging the attorney general to show everybody, ready? Show everybody your evidence there was no mass fraud. Are you serious? Senator, please show us evidence that you are not a fool. Let's make this easy. How about asking Trump for the evidence that there is fraud? None of them has even asked, ever. We know why. They know there is no proof, and they know that it has nothing to do with the truth for Trump or for them. You want the truth of how they would see this situation? Just change an R to a D and go back 4 years. Listen to what the person steering what was the Republican Party, the head of the RNC, Ronna McDaniel, said about exactly what she's selling right now. Recount efforts in Michigan by Jill Stein. She was the Green Party candidate back then. Our friends at CNN's K-File, they find you when you defy. And they dug this up.
In our state, who got 1% of the vote, is now going to cost the Michigan taxpayers up to $2 million just so that we can do a recount that will not change anything. And she has not shown any fraud or inconsistencies with our election system. It's something she just thinks we need to do. We have integrity in our system. Wow. The votes were certified on Monday. There's been no evidence of any election issues, fraud, or hacking. I think this is a wasted effort. I think it's unfortunate that she's putting the voters of Michigan through this process, but I'm confident that in the end, Donald Trump will remain the victor in Michigan.
What's changed? Just her interests, not the circumstances. Same thing here, not a shred of proof. That's why she and the others are re-Trumplicans. Shame on you. Fresh off his pardon, Trump's disgraced former national security advisor is now openly encouraging the president to declare martial law and hold a new election. Can't say he ain't grateful. The tweet is here from Flynn. How do Republicans respond to this? Silence. The suggestion of a coup? Silence. Overthrowing democracies, now patriotic? Oh, vaunted protectors of the flag. Be honest and know this. The only flag you've waved for the last 4 years has been white. A sign of simple surrender. And look where it got you. Sidney Powell, Trump lawyer-ish, kicked off the team, now urging Georgians ahead of the runoffs, don't vote. Protest the state's November election results. Another Trump loyalist, Lynn Wood, joining her, rallying the crowd to chant, lock up the Republican governor who certified Biden's victory there. Now what are you going to do? You see, when you stand for nothing, your party will fall when faced with anything. And that's what we are seeing in real time. But this is no time just to point out the obvious about their problems. There must be light in the darkness. And there is a chance for crisis to allow both parties to show their best. When times are at their worst, people pay attention and hope for the best. What will we see? History gives us hope. There was division when FDR faced the Depression. The New Deal was not an easy sell. There was a lot of rejection of the New Deal. So how did FDR rally the country and thus its representatives? A reminder that government's job boils down to pretty simple securing of four freedoms for the American people, illustrated beautifully by Norman Rockwell, and they live throughout history. You remember these. You've seen them. Everybody thinks that's Lincoln standing up, right? Freedom from want, freedom from fear, freedom of speech, and freedom of worship. Just the first two alone demand immediate action. This country has not faced fear or want the way it will over the next few months, not in a generation. The head of the CDC is finally using his voice, warning that the darkest months in U.S. health history are coming. We just surpassed 100,000 current COVID hospitalizations, highest number since the pandemic began. Today, we broke another record for deaths, the highest number of a new number of deaths in a day. More than 2,600 lives lost. The United States could be close to 450,000 deaths before February. We can't do better than this. Oh, don't worry, there's a vaccine. When? Not for months. And who told you a vaccine is a cure? You think you get sick, you get the vaccine, you're better? It's not how it works, and you know it. We need to rally this country right now to the remedies that we control. And our biggest need is leadership. Congress must shake free from Trump trauma. Remember what once inspired you to seek office. Do it now. I know you watch the show. Thank you. So allow me to say to you all directly, what will you do now? Not weeks from now. The answer may well define how you will be remembered. And remember this, I guarantee you, People like me doing this job all over this country will never let people forget who stepped up and who fell back. Now is the time. The challenge is great, the stakes are high, and you are aware. For me and my audience, there is only one direction. It's to take it on. So let's get after it.